Thank you, Kevin. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow candidate, fellow school candidates. I am not going to repeat everything that's in my pamphlet. I like talking about myself, but I don't think people want to hear it again when you can read it. So I'm going to just talk a little bit about what I did put in the pamphlet. First, some of my education experiences on council. One of my best experiences was to go into the elected officials education program. It was a series of courses that you had to take to graduate, and what Helen Sear and I did graduate from. And the advantage of the courses were like governance, on finance, on sustainability, on all sorts of issues like that. Was when we decided the course, we sat around with other people, other counselors, some very experienced, and I learned a lot from listening and talking to them. Another course I took, which we haven't had in the MD for a long time, because nobody appeals or assessment for that. Quinton is here too. Him and I went to Red Deer for a week, and we took an assessment appeal course, so we're qualified to get involved in case somebody wants to appeal their assessment. Okay, I'm going to start off with a couple of topics that came up while I was campaigning. One of the big issues that it appeared, and one of the things I got a lot of contact about, was Todd Creek and the culvert. Well, the culvert was designed to handle the catch basin on a 25-year flood. And it was basically done by the provincial government, and we didn't argue, hey, it's bigger, we have to build a road up a little bit, because they paid 80% of the cost. And when somebody pays 80% of the cost, it seems sensible to do it their way. One of the topics that's probably pretty important to deal with is the water supply and what's happened to regional water. When I first got on council, we were all excited because we had $16.5 million to work on regional water. The water treatment plant in Lumbrick was on special permit, it was outdated, the one in Cali was outdated. So we were supposed to go with our partners, Pincher Creek. So what we did after a lot of discussion and help from the province, first Pincher was worried about the treatment plant. Well, most of the money would help build them a new treatment plant. They were worried about the water supply. We could have had a pipeline into the deep part of the dam. We would be like left. We would have no restrictions unless things got really bad. So finally, after a lot of talk, Pincher kind of agreed to go with us. So we sat down with the contract, and in the contract, they had a clause that no new water hookups could happen in the MD without the Trump Town's approval. All five councillors said this was unacceptable. The town didn't bend on it, so we went to Plan B, regional water between Cowley and London. And obviously, that took a little delay, and we're just about there now. We're just about getting in the dam. We're waiting for fisheries, and hopefully, because besides the $9.6 million we got to do that project, we got $1.6 million to go into the dam. So we're just about there. But that might not totally solve our water supply or pitchers, because when the river gets down to a certain level, there's restrictions. So that'd be one topic. Another topic I would like to talk about that people seem to be excited about is the so-called incinerator. You hear about comparing apples and oranges. Well, this is like comparing a watermelon to a raisin. The purpose of the incinerator is we have a lot of dead animals brought to the landfill. 400 roadkill, pigs, chickens, horses. We can't take beef. So we looked at what are the solutions, because the workers are working in a very smelly area. And biosecurity, if there's a disease there, the scavengers could spread it all over. So we decided that we needed a solution. We looked at Newfoundland, where they had used a certain type of incinerator to deal with moose, and in Ontario, where they dealt with dead horses. This is brand new technology, just developed in the last 10 to 15 years. It's not very big, it's about the size of a sea camp. It's top loaded. What happens is you put dead animals in to help the burning. You put untreated wood, such as branches and that. The thing is heated up to 1,000 degrees for about 8 hours. It's a crematorium. The animals and that are virtually turned to carbon starts. And this exhaust goes into another chamber where it's superheated again. And once again, All the toxins are broken up into the chemical elements. There's very little release. The air coming out of it, the toxins, are cleaner than an urban area, than the air you breathe in an urban area. So the first step, we decided on that. We had meetings. Very few people attended them. And then we applied now for a license from the province, and which we're waiting for right now. We have to answer some complaint letters, and we have to wait for the toxin report, which they're working on. So, and then another step we have, once we get that license, we've got to find out how we're going to finance it. It's going to cost about $4.5 to $5 million. So once we find out who's going to give us grants, we hope the CFIA, if we can deal with the Pierons of livestock with it, we'll be ready to go. Then we have the big meeting where we decide if we're going to build it. There's been no decision to build it. We just want to get all our ducks in a row before we talk about that part. So that's my little part about incinerator. You could ask me more money. Ask me more about it. And the next thing is economic development and what's going on in the area. Well, one of our biggest industries is the school. It provides jobs, teachers, bus drivers. In 5 minutes, I'm going to hurry up here. Anyway, the school is extremely important. To help it out, one of the things we should have is a daycare. We got one ask from the town of Pincher Creek of $1 to $2 million to build a new daycare in Pincher in the future. I don't think MD will put a lot of money into it, but we will definitely support and help out between Cowley and Lumbert of us building a daycare, because we can get more people to stay here, live here, and go to school here. One of the big industries I see that's developing is retirement. We see some older, mature people, some of them are my neighbors, moving into the community. They have good incomes, they buy a lot of goods and services, and they're going to provide a lot of jobs to the local people. Speaking of jobs, I was surprised how many local places I've seen that they're contractors. He just buzzed me off. I'm waiting for a lot of questions. Anyway, I'm very optimistic about the future of the MD and the future of this Division 5. One thing that does bother me a little bit, we got 626 households in Division 5. And in Division 1 and 2, there's only 200. So whatever's going to happen in Cowley, maybe that's a chance for redistribution, because I don't think we had redistribution since the MD's been formed back in 1941.
Before my time.
So, and I would like to see an MD that has 7 councillors. Being a councillor takes a lot of time up. There's a lot of responsibilities. And when I was on school board, the old Pincher Creek school board for that, those 3 terms, it was nice to have 7 people. You always had some of them staying around for 1 or 2 elections, 3 elections, you had some experience, and then you always had new people came in and they got trained and helped by the old one. And very seldomly we had votes that weren't more than 7-7, but always majority votes. Except we had some people who believed that you should give money back to the province. So when we got that $807,000 to build a new gym and convert our old gym into a library and a theater, that kind of fell apart. That's because some of the people, the other 6 people, thought our kids should go to the Pincher, because they were good basketball players. But it's an MD that is not wasting money. We're very careful about it. We're very considerate about what's going to happen in the future. We're watching what options there are. And yes, the province gives us money, but remember, a lot of that money comes from our pockets too. And the school boards, they don't get the share. When you pay taxes, about 30% of it goes back to the province. We don't get 30% of it spent in the Livingston Range. So it's all our money. I know the federal money is our money too. When I say VSE is a problem, we can handle it. And it doesn't matter if the incinerator never pays for itself. The landfill is not there.
It's how much time?
You're about done.
Anyway, for you people who live in Lumbert, I still haven't hit Lumbert yet, so in the next 3 days or so, I might be knocking on your door. Please lock your mean dog up.